Thank you, friends. So happy Independence Day. Just like a bird has to have two wings, one representing a material wing and the other one representing a sublime aspect of life, the spiritual wing. Then only we can soar up higher and higher and take pleasure of life. And that is the true meaning of freedom. So freedom comes with balance. Freedom of mind comes with true knowledge. Freedom of the mind comes with true love, unconditional love. So I wish you true independence, the real independence, the real freedom, the real joy on this auspicious India's Independence Day. So I hope you're celebrating in many different ways with your loved ones in a lockdown situation, still aspiring to open up. So that's the challenge given to us. How creative can we be to open up our mind, to open up our heart, to open up our soul in this lockdown situation? That's why this phrase that came to my mind, Muktir Ananda. Just like an imprisoned person getting that freedom for the first time after many, many years of suffering. So you should experience that right now. Just have a feeling of freedom. Because in Arogya, we talk about yoga, mindfulness, meditation. So it's more experiential rather than just talking and listening. So I would encourage you to take a couple of mindful breaths at this moment, whatever you're doing, as much as possible, keeping the safety into the first place. So while being safe, even if you keep your eyes open, just take a couple of mindful breaths and try to feel that freedom within. Actually speaking, we are not bound to anything. With an open mind, we are always free. If we accept any challenge that the universe is offering, and if you understand it is only a lesson to learn, we can always experience that freedom of mind. So let's invite that freedom of our being, freedom of our speech, freedom of our breath. And also freedom comes with responsibilities. We're not free to do anything that can harm somebody, that can hurt someone. We are responsible. So we have to enjoy the freedom responsibly, within the boundaries, understanding everyone's happiness, everyone else's freedom also. Then only we can enjoy the freedom. So giving breathing space to each one that we encounter, that we share our life with, experiencing joy and freedom with them. So take a couple of mindful breaths to experience some deeper aspects of freedom. One of the most difficult things to think about is financial freedom, because we are tied up so much to different conditions, different situations. The local economy, the global economy, the technological revolutions, there's so much of things happening. So let's aspire for financial freedom also today. Let's take a few more breaths to feel like we are becoming financially free. Free from all the debts before we retire, so that you can really enjoy the rest of life. You know that aspiration is very important. Once we have a deeper aspiration, bigger aspirations, then only the universe will help us to realize those goals, those dreams. So we are free to dream big today, because it's our Independence Day. So everyone who is listening to this talk right now, please feel free to dream big. Take a couple of more mindful breaths and try to energize your dreams. Think about the dreams that you had during your childhood time and see how many of those have already been fulfilled. And feel grateful for those already fulfilled. Like I remember when I was a little child, whenever there was a plane going in the sky, flying in the sky, I used to see and I used to feel and I used to dream that I'll also fly one day. So that freedom is very much associated with our thoughts, with our childhood upbringing. So try to remember back the freedom that you enjoyed during your childhood time. And even if you had a difficult moment, some suffering happened, since you have already overcome the time, try to recreate that moment again in your mind, as if you chose to be in that situation, but still you enjoyed the so-called freedom. If you have a heavy heart for someone or for something that didn't happen the way you wanted, you have anger, you have stress, you have a lot of questions, a lot of doubts, please take this moment to experience freedom of forgiveness. Try to take this moment to forgive that person, forgive that event that happened, forgive your own self, because things happen out of ignorance, out of anger, out of frustration, out of annoyance. So whatever that cause could be, on this Independence Day, let us celebrate a happy heart with no negativity. Let's try to forgive lots of people who might have done some mistake, some hurtful things to our life. Let's forgive our own self for causing some deeper damage to body, mind and soul. And let's wake up to this new moment of joy, freedom, happiness, peace, harmony within. Let's pray forward together for a wonderful time ahead with a healthy body, healthy mind, and an uplifted spirit to enjoy the rest of the life with this true sense of freedom for our own self and for everyone in this entire world, in this entire universe. Let's aspire for true freedom for the humankind, for everyone, for every creature in this planet. That's what the prayer goes. Sarvesham swastir bhavatu, sarvesham shantir bhavatu, sarvesham purnam bhavatu, sarvesham mangalam bhavatu. Om Purnamadha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. That means we are always free, we are always full, we are always happy and blissful. Nothing to add, nothing to delete. We are Satchidananda. So with that prayer, friends, let's celebrate the rest of the day, the rest of the week, the rest of the month, the rest of the year and the rest of the life with total freedom in our mind, in our heart. Enjoy the Independence Day. Namaste, friends.